our university to speak to people like yourself, and your youth engagement service network has done so much in this country that I think you owe a huge appreciation for your efforts to engage youth in this country. And I was really impressed to know that you have covered 1,200 educational and vocational institutions where you have ventured and worked with youth on different projects. And you're also a survey scholar, which is a huge honor for the country as well, not just for us to, for yourself and for us to have a person like yourself discussing different aspects of your organization, especially the book which you've written. Is something which when I was discussing it with my colleagues, they were so inspired, and they were saying that we hope we could join it live to ask him questions, to sort of have direct interaction with them. And I said that that would be done in future very soon. And absolutely. Right. And especially this concept of change making intelligence, we've known emotional intelligence, we've known so many types of intelligence, but this change making intelligence is something I think very inspiring, not just for the youth, but for the people of my age and my education background as well, because we work as leaders of an organization, and we need to know exactly how change works and what sort of strategies we need to adopt. But coming back to your book, I will quickly take you to this concept which you've shared through this book. Could you shed some light on this concept, please, for us?
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much for this grand introduction. Actually, it is a great honor for me to have you with us today. See, you are among those people that have really embedded this and embraced this concept and this struggle. So it is such a privilege to talk to you, and thank you so much for inspiring leadership, because you are one of those persons that took the initiative and started this process in the university and enriched like so many young girls. So it's such a pleasure to have this conversation with you, first of all. So coming back to your question, what is change-making intelligence and why I have written this book? Actually, the whole idea behind writing this book is to introduce, as we have mentioned, that a new kind of intelligence. I call this change-making intelligence. I believe that large number of young people today are cut off from the society, because the way we define intelligence, the way we define, assess the potential of young people. You see, large number of young people feel that they are out of touch with the society, because this is how society defines, intelligence success for them. Unless and until we change the definition of intelligence, we cannot basically provide a space to large number of young people to reintegrate into the society. The reason I've written this book is to create a space for large number of young people in Pakistan who are not only out of school, but in school also, because they have less enormous capacity to drive change in the society. But unfortunately, society holds it back. You see, if I ask you this question, how many young people today are just against academic excellence, against IQ, you would say that most of the young people today are just against this criteria. And my argument in the book is that, academic excellence is not the only criteria to assess the potential of young people, but it should not be the sole criteria to assess the potential of young people. Because academic intelligence doesn't help you right now to develop a sense of connection with the society, to create a sense of usefulness, a sense of productivity. And most importantly, if you see that what is happening in the education institutions of Pakistan, young people are out of touch with the reality. They are out of touch with their society. And I think, we need to create a space for them so that they can also unleash their inherent ability to drive change in society. And I am trying to basically redefine intelligence by including a kind of intelligence which is present in all human beings, which comes to us naturally by God.
Right, thank you very much. It's very enlightening to listen to you. And I've seen you actually in action and in the previous university when I was heading there, and I could see that there was a total transformation, and there was a second round. I was not there at the time, but I was communicated about the success of the intervention at that time. It is important for our young students to understand, our youth needs to understand that the real strength is inside them. And all they need to have is good opportunity. And institutions need to do that. And it is not just just the instruction within that rectangular classroom which matters. It is the opportunity out there and the tools which they get through such interaction, which will help them establish and locate themselves well in the society. Thank you very much for your time and the way you've conveyed this change-making intelligence idea to us. I would take this opportunity to request you to start some kind of online marathon of ideas with our students.
I would love to.
Just helping them think through different ideas which they, while even in such a situation where you're you're locked in your house and you have to learn online. Sometimes back, I remember when we started blended learning in the previous university, and quite a bit of courses were online. Students were much happier with online courses because then they could do things in their own time. It will take some time for the students to really understand what this online learning and teaching and learning is all about. But during this time period, if you could have some interactive sessions with live sessions with our students and faculty so that we could come up with our version and our way of implementing this change-making intelligence idea being implemented in an educational institution. Thank you so much for your time.
We hope to
see more of you in future, and we'll have more talks such as this one.
Sure.
Thank you so much, and good luck with the promotion.
My pleasure. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Sam. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.